everyone, my name is Sandy Brandes and today I have a video for you that is a little bit different. I want to share with you my 10 best tips on how to be happy during the COVID lockdown and also in general. So get yourself something to drink, make yourself comfortable and let's start. I realize that I'm a very positive and happy person even in difficult situations and many people have asked me why I'm always so happy. So I thought why not make a video and share my secrets about how to be happy and positive. But first I want to say that I'm not a psychologist, so if you're having real problems with depression or anxiety, it is very important that you get professional help. Don't forget that you are not alone with it and you should never be afraid to talk about it. Let's start with tip number one, go into nature. Fresh air and light is essential for your well-being, especially when it's getting cold outside, we often don't like to go out. But when you go for a walk or bike ride, I promise you will feel so much better after. Besides, it is great for your immune system. If you don't have the chance to go out, let a lot of fresh air into your house by opening the windows regularly. And if you have the chance to go out, really try to do this every single day, integrate it into your day as a daily routine. Which brings me to point number two, create a daily routine. Especially when you can't work at the moment or when you are working from home, it is so important that you create a structure in your day. Write down in the morning or the previous evening what you want to accomplish in the day and set a specific time for it. Especially when you are working from home, set a regular time to work and also plan breaks for yourself. Then also have some daily routines like a workout, meditation or some reading in the morning. Be thankful for the fact that you have more time now and use it for having daily routines that make you happy. Which brings me to point number three, see the changes as an opportunity. Maybe you always wanted to work out more, do yoga, meditate or read good books. Now is the perfect time, so don't waste it. The worst feeling is when you go back to normal life and you regret that you didn't use the time you had. Maybe you can use the time to learn something new, learn to cook, to dance, to draw, whatever it is. Use the time you have for your growth. It is a great opportunity, don't waste it. Maybe you even lost your job, which is sad, of course, and it's totally okay to be angry and sad. But I believe that everything happens for a reason. Maybe something better is waiting for you, or maybe you always wanted to create your own business and you weren't brave enough to change. Now is the time, now is the opportunity, be brave and go for it. Which brings me to point number four, have a goal. As humans we need a purpose in our life, we need to grow, to work for something in order to be happy. It is not reaching your goal that will bring you happiness, maybe for some time, but true happiness lies in enjoying the journey of realizing your goals. Set yourself a new goal for the lockdown time. It doesn't have to be something big. Maybe you want to learn a handstand or learn 10 new words in a foreign language every week. Integrate the practice for your goal into your daily routine and enjoy the process. Tip number 5. Stop complaining. Your words influence your mood more than you think. If you are constantly complaining and blaming other people or circumstances for your situation, you won't be happy. It is easy to make yourself think that you are a victim, especially if other people are showing their pity. But you are not a victim. You have the power to take action. You have the power to be responsible for your life. Of course, there are also things that you can't control, but stop focusing on them. Instead, focus on what you can control. Ask yourself, who do you want to be in these times? Someone who spreads fear or someone who grows through difficulty and spreads hope? Sometimes it's hard to be positive when there's so much negativity around us. Don't tune into the same energy. Instead, try to change the topic into something more positive if the person you're talking to is constantly complaining. I'm not saying don't listen to someone's problems. It is very important to be there for someone who's having a hard time and to listen and understand. But if someone is constantly making himself a victim and talking negative, it will pull you down as well. If it's not possible for you to shift the conversation into something more positive, you can politely ask the person to change the topic. For example, you could say, "Could we please change the topic? I've heard enough about the corona topic. Better tell me about your plans to refurbish your house." Let's get to tip number 6. Choose mindfully what you are consuming. Especially the news are extremely dramatic and negative. Of course, there's a lot of terrible things happening in this world. But there was always a lot of terrible things, and there always will be. But there's also a lot of positive things happening in this world. The reason why the negative news dominate is because most humans react much more strongly to negative information than to positive ones. This phenomenon is called negativity bias. The news programs are using it for their advantage by making the news look as shocking, as dramatic as possible. It is up to you if you want to watch the news or not. In my opinion, it's better to not watch them because they're too dramatized. If there's something important you need to know, you will know anyway, because people will talk about it. However, if you want to keep watching the news, I would suggest to better read about the news or listen on the radio instead of watching it. The news on TV are the most dramatized because they can work with negative videos and photos to get the viewers' attention. Another tip is to not consume first thing in the morning and last thing in the evening, because it can make you lose the connection to yourself. Spend the first hour in the morning with just yourself to set your goals, tune into the right energy, to be thankful. And the last hour of your day you can spend to reflect your day and also to practice gratitude. Which brings me to the next point, gratitude. Gratitude is, in my opinion, the most powerful tool to make you happy. It will help you to shift your focus on all that is positive, which will bring even more positivity into your life. You can practice gratitude by having a gratitude journal, so you would write down 3 things in the morning or evening that you are grateful for. Or you can have a gratitude stone, so in the evening you would hold your stone and you would choose one moment of the day that you're most thankful for. And by doing that, you would go through all the nice moments of your day. Or you can also practice gratitude with your children or your partner, so you would tell each other what your most beautiful moment was and say thank you for it. And it doesn't have to be something big. It's about being grateful for the small things in your life, like having great food in your fridge, having flowers in the garden, a nice warm autumn day, or the smile of a child. Maybe we can all share what we're grateful for today in the comments below, so we get more inspiration from each other. If you find it hard to be thankful for something because you're really feeling miserable, there's something else you need to do first, which we discuss in point number 8. All emotions are valid. No one is always happy. And it shouldn't be your goal to always be happy. Your goal should be to be content. By this, I mean no matter what emotion you are going through, experience it fully, 100%. If you are sad, allow yourself to cry. If you are angry, allow yourself to fully be angry. Every emotion has its right to be there. Suppressing your emotions can lead to physical stress on your body. To truly be happy, you also need to have moments of sadness, anger, or frustration. You are human and it is completely normal. If you feel like it, you can share your feelings with a person you trust, and after you will feel so much better. Which brings me to point number 9. Be social. Now you might think, how can I be social in times of social distancing? Being social doesn't always mean you have to be with many people. In fact, studies show that people with 3 to 5 friends report the highest level of life satisfaction. But even if you have less friends, or if you can't see them because of the lockdown, maybe you are living with your family or your children, use the time to intensify your relationship, play games, support each other, have deep conversations, whatever it is, try to be as social as possible. If you are living alone and there's no one you can meet, then it is very important to still keep in contact with people. Maybe call an old friend, call a family member. Do video calls. I know we're all sick of video calls, but it is so important to stay in touch with people. As humans, we are social beings. Being social is not only important for your happiness, but also for your health. Research shows that chronic loneliness can have a significant impact on your overall health, including our brain health. Studies even suggest that there may be a link between loneliness and an increased risk for developing dementia and Alzheimer's. But don't worry, this cannot happen after just a few weeks at home. But anyway, it shows how important it is to be social, so try to be as social as possible. Okay, now we already come to the last point, number 10, take care of your health. Besides being social, it is crucial that you eat well, stay active and take care of your mental health. Malnutrition induces a stress response within the body, which can cause depression or other mental health problems. Our bodies need healthy and real food to regulate biological processes that keep us physically and mentally healthy, such as repairing tissue, removing toxins, and balancing hormones. But also remember to tune into your body to make sure you only eat when you are hungry. There are some foods that are known to boost your mood and to make you happy, which are quinoa, salmon, mushrooms, dark chocolate, food with probiotics like yogurt or kefir, B6 vitamins from leafy greens or grapes. But I think that everyone's body is so different, so you should really listen to what your body needs, as long as it's not always sweets and fast food. Also take care of your mental health. We talked about being social before, but what is also important is to simply keep your brain working. Especially if you are not working at the moment, it is very important that you still keep learning. Read a book, learn something new, just keep growing. Studies show that boredom over a long period of time can cause overeating, depression, and anxiety. So don't give boredom a chance. When you are dealing with anxiety or stress, start to meditate. It doesn't have to be long. Only 5 minutes a day can help you to reduce negative emotions. If you never meditated before, try it with an app or a YouTube video. If you want to meditate with me, click on the link up here. Another tip is to make your home as comfortable as possible. You are spending so much time at home at the moment. Use the time to sort out some stuff, put some nice fairy lights on, light a candle, and have some hot tea. And don't forget, happiness is enjoying the little things in life. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you could get some inspiration from this video. If you're having any further questions, don't hesitate to ask me in the comments below. I wish you that you stay happy and healthy during this quarantine. And don't forget that you're not alone. Lots of love, yours, Sandy.